Hi, I'm Kirsten Mangers. I'm Managing Director of Chick Labs, and you're watching Eye on Business.
I'm Chris Placell, founder of Red Knight Consulting, and you are watching Eye on Business.
Welcome, I'm Kevin McDonald, and you're watching Eye on Business Innovation, and today with me is Kevin Strom with GlobeChat. GlobeChat happens to be the winner of the Tech Coast Angel Celebration of Entrepreneurship, which happened here last week, and with us today is going to be the CEO and founder, and I really appreciate your coming in.
My pleasure.
So, why don't you tell me a little bit about what it's like to win a Tech Coast Angels Entrepreneurship Award?
It's actually an honor. There was 120 companies that actually entered into it, and they were pre-screened, and to be selected among such amazing other companies is an extreme honor. It was an incredible night for us, and we went out and celebrated afterwards and went back home and went back to work.
Yeah, and that celebration, I'm guessing, lasted about 5 minutes in a startup and then went right back to work
again, huh? Yeah, we're always focused on improving.
Yeah, so tell me a little bit about what GlobeChat does.
So what GlobeChat does is it gives you the ability to send a message on your mobile device in English to 40 different people in 40 different countries. Each of them will see it in their own language instantly. So we basically made it simple for you to communicate with anyone on the planet. Mm-hmm. So for example, if you wanted to send a message to someone right now in Paris, you send them a message and they would see it in French. You send it to someone in Germany, they'd see it in German. So we made it very simple to communicate with people around the planet.
That's pretty mind-blowing. I can tell you we provide help desk services and technology. And one of the things we tend to do is use Google translation engines to do
It's painful.
That. It's painful and expensive.
My heart goes out to you.
It's expensive for the client, too. So
yeah.
I can't wait to see this technology in real time. Is it being offered now commercially?
April 1st, 2016, it will be available on the App Store for Apple, Android, Windows. And we also have a computerized version as well because we want to connect with people even maybe in a small village in Africa. Maybe they just have one computer, they don't have cell phones. Mm-hmm. We want to make it available to everyone in the world in some format.
That's very cool. So what is the financial model? How do you bill for the service?
We're not charging anything. It's
really?
Free,
okay.
Which normally people would say that's not a really good financial model because the ROI, if it's free, you get nothing back. What we want to do is create a large user base right off the bat. Mm-hmm. And if you charge for an app, you're going to lose 80% of the population. Mm-hmm. So when you launch an app, you want to make sure it's free. And we want to make sure that people can connect. Now, down the road, we will probably charge 99 cents or $1.99 per year. And if we have a billion users like WhatsApp has, every 99 cents equates to $1 billion of revenue per year.
Yeah, and I think that those that support Facebook would be reticent to say that free services don't pay, right?
So yes.
You get enough user base and it ultimately pays, and that's
yep.
a great idea.
Free service does pay if you have a larger company that's willing to pay for that company that doesn't make any revenue but has a large user base.
So it's a fantastic idea, but it's kind of random. Where did you come up with the concept of doing translation? Was it something that you've been frustrated by, somebody you know? I mean, what drew you to doing this particular technology?
I love travel. It's one of my favorite hobbies. I love meeting new people and I love learning about new cultures because generally in social media you communicate with people within your own culture, but you learn so much more when you sit down in a coffee shop in just a remote village and talk to people. It's so fascinating. So when I travel, I notice that when I came back, there's these people that I still want to keep in touch with, but you lose track of them because like you said, Google Translate, you cut, you paste. Eventually, you get really busy with your life, you start moving on to other things, and you lose track of these people that you had some sort of a connection with. So we just wanted to make it nice and simple. When you meet someone on a trip, you know, you can communicate with them. You send them a message. You can even do voice to text. You could want to send a message to a new friend in Italy, and you're driving in your car. You can talk into your phone, hit send, and they will get it in Italian on their phone instantly. So for me, it was just a way to connect the world. I just realized that no one has made it very simple. It's tough to cut and paste. Wow. We just wanted to make it extremely simple for everybody.
Well, it sounds like a really fabulous technology. Let me ask you a little bit about the company structure. So are you currently, do you have investors? I know that this was a TechCoast Angels event, so I believe you got some benefit. What was the prize that you got out of the TechCoast Angels event?
I'm honored to say we got two prizes. We won the number one company, best company overall, so we got a $20,000 prize for that. We also won the audience favorite, which that award makes me very happy because I guess we connected with the audience as mm-hmm. well. For that, we got an office space in Newport Beach for a full year.
Right.
So we have a second office now.
Yeah, well, what are you going to do when you have to go back to the? No, I'm kidding. It's funny. Maybe you guys may do so well, you'll be able to stay in Newport. That would be really great.
Yeah, well, I mean, we don't mind. We have a really nice office down in San Juan Capistrano. We love the traffic down mm-hmm. in South Orange County. Mm-hmm. So Newport's not too bad. So as long as we go during non-traffic hours, we just have another place to hang out if we're waiting for traffic to go by.
So while we have a minute, tell me a little bit about your team. What does it take to do what you're doing? Most people in the general public see the hard results of many years of work, but they really don't understand how you get there. So tell me a little bit about your team and a little bit about your journey.
Yeah, it's actually taken us 5 years. There is a lot that has gone into
it. It's not overnight, 5 years.
It is 5 years. I mean, it's crazy. We have 30 programmers and developers, and the amount of programming that's gone into it. The reason why we want it so complicated on the back end is because we want to make it very simple on the front end. Mm-hmm. And we have just created this network with these 30 programmers and developers. We're on the phone with them sometimes till 2-3 o'clock in the morning, and we just, they're part of us now. A lot of them we haven't even met. They're overseas,
and yet
they feel like family. So it's been an extremely long journey, but right now it's very rewarding because when you work hard for 5 years and finally you get a chance to celebrate and go up on stage and talk about what you've created, it's mm-hmm. so much more rewarding when you know how much has gone into getting to that point.
Yeah, I could see where that would be a pretty great thing to do. In the minute that we have left, where do we expect to see GlobeChat in the next 12 months?
Well, we are launching on April 1st. Our goal is to get people on from all over the world. We have interns from different countries that are going to be promoting it. We've spoken with the United Nations. We spoke with the State Department. There's a lot of people that are very excited about it. So in the next 12 months, we are just going to try and get as many people around the world on board with it. If anyone wants to see and track it, we're on Facebook. We like to stay up on other social media, even though we are a social media company ourselves.
Makes sense completely.
So if you go to GlobeChat on Facebook, you can just track to see where we are at.
Fantastic. Well, thank you so much for
coming.
Thank you. Thank you for being an innovator. We need more entrepreneurs today. I can assure you I will be using this. I'll be telling my team about it as soon as I get back to the office. I'm Kevin McDonald. This has been an episode of EyeOnBusiness Innovation, and thanks for watching.
We have our first customer.